Hi everyone, how are you doing? My name is Valeria and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a pick a card reading for you in which you will find out what does your crush feel about you. So as you can see, I've got four piles in front of me. But before we choose our piles and do the short meditative exercise to get us in the zone, I want to quickly let you know that if you want to book a private reading with me, all the information for that is there in the description box below. Now, this is pile 1, pile 2, 3 and 4. And what I want you to do is, I want you to sit back comfortably, close your eyes and take in a deep breath. Hold it in for a few seconds and let it out. And once you're feeling completely calm and composed, I want you to open your eyes and choose the pile that draws your eyes the most. So I'll leave the timestamps in the description box below, but now I'm going to start with pile number 1 over here. Hey pile number 1, so if you chose this paper marker, let's find out what does your crush feel about you. So I'm going to tell you what your crush feels about you first, and then I'll tell you what your crush is actually like as a person. So wait till the end for that. Alright, so we have got the reversed 5 of swords. We have the Hierophant. We have the sun in reversed. We have the 4 pentacles in reversed and the chariot. Okay, very interesting. Very interesting. Alright. So with the Hierophant over here, I'm getting the feeling that your crush feels you are somebody who is quite spiritual or religious, and you have very firm beliefs when it comes to spirituality or religion. They feel that you're somebody who will never take advantage of anybody. But they feel that you are somebody who gets taken advantage of sometimes. I don't know how long your person has known you, but this is what they have picked up about you. They feel that you're very focused on your career, or you have big dreams and you want to go ahead and achieve something in this world, in your career. But I'm also getting the feeling that you are not exactly going after your dreams. Yes, you have these big dreams. You are very ambitious. You're very career oriented. But there's something that is stopping you from actually walking on the path that you want to walk on. And I think it's fear. Fear of losing money. That is like a big thing for you. Also leaving your comfort zone. But it's like deep inside in your heart, you already know what is it that you want to accomplish in this world, in your life, what would make you really, really happy. And it's not just something that is like, a lot of people have life purposes which are like more domestic in nature, okay? Like what brings them real joy is probably raising children, or, you know, being a teacher, or, you know, selling cakes at a bakery, okay? So these are small things. But in your case, your career is like, and it's not just a small thing, your career. This dream of yours is connected to your career, and you have a very, very big dream. So your person, your crush, they can actually see this about you. But they also feel that you are allowing your emotions and your fears to stop you. Yeah. 5 is the number of chaos. Okay, and it is also the number of the mind. So you really need to, I think your crush also feels that you are a little bit of an overthinker. Maybe that's why you are stalling yourself. But yeah, that is there. It's a very clear-cut thing what your crush feels about you. So I am getting feeling that maybe your crush does not know you for very long, because it's like just bits and pieces here and there. It's not a full story. It's like this is what they know about you based on how long they have actually known you. So I'm going to tell you about your crush right now. What are they like as a person? So we have the swan spirit. We have the sandpiper spirit. Wow, so cute. We have time to collaborate, dolphin spirit, and dove spirit. Okay, very interesting. Okay. So as a person, your crush, the person you have a crush on, they are also very focused on their career, but not to the extent that you are. This is a person who's a team player, okay? They have a lot of friends, and they're very playful, very energetic, very charming. But this person, on the surface, they may look like this, okay? Very friendly, very humorous, and all of this stuff. But deep inside, this person is the kind who is like a swan. They mate only once in the lifetime. So it's like, if your person decides that this individual is my person, they're gonna be loyal to this person for the rest of their life. That is the kind of energy that your individual has. They're very loving, they're very kind, but this is something that you will get a glimpse of, obviously, when you meet them. But you will get to know more of this once you get to know them even more. And your crush actually does not like dramatic displays. They prefer things to be harmonious and peaceful. It's like they love the, you know, it's like they are the kind of person for whom the romantic partner needs to be a friend first before they become a romantic partner. All right. And they're also very, very intelligent. Although they can fool around a bit and they're very quick-witted and all of that stuff, humorous here and there. But they're also very, very intelligent. Very, very emotionally intelligent as well. Intelligent and emotionally intelligent. And yeah, your crush is definitely a very good team player. Okay? And very protective as well. So the people he or she cares about, they'll do everything they can to protect them. Okay, this is the kind of person who, if they really, really love someone, they will not hesitate to even give their life for that person. Okay, if it comes to that, that is the kind of energy this individual has. Okay, but yeah, I do feel that your crush hasn't known you for too long, and that's why the energies that I got from how they feel about you are just like those things that we get to know about somebody from like meeting them maybe once or twice or a few times, you know, as an acquaintance. These are the things that we know about somebody. Yeah. And things that we pick up when we have a conversation with them. But yeah, they don't really know you as a person. So maybe you can start interacting with them a little bit more, because if you have a crush and they seem like a nice person, be playful, be intelligent. I think this person likes people who are kind, who are good-hearted, you know, who are gentle, because they are like that as well. So pile number one, that's pretty much all I have got for you. If you enjoyed this reading, let me know what you think in the comments and hit the like button below. And if you've not subscribed to the channel yet, please do subscribe. Also, if you would like to book a private reading with me, all the information for that is there in the description box below. So yeah, that's pretty much it for today. I hope you have a great day ahead, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Hi, pile number two. So if you chose this marker, let's find out what does your crush feel about you. And in the end, I'm also going to tell you who your crush is like as a person. I mean, what your crush is like as a person. Now, when I was meditating on this paper marker over here, because this represents your collective energy, I got the feeling that for some of you, your crush actually really likes flowers. So this is going to apply to those of you who are masculine, as in your men who are watching this, or you know, are attracted to women. So this is specifically to those of you, because I'm getting that your crush, if it's a feminine person, they really like flowers. Now, let's get to the main reading, which is we have death over here. Okay. Three of Pentacles, Nine of Cups, and Three of Wands. All right, very interesting. Okay. I think your crush feels that you're a very busy person. You could be a Scorpio, but with Death over here and the Nine of Cups over here, I'm getting a lot of water energy. So, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. And basically, what I'm getting is that the first thing that your crush feels is that you're somebody who is very hardworking or very focused on your work, okay? You seem like a workaholic. But if not a workaholic, it's almost like when you're working, you don't like to be disturbed, okay? And that's why we have this lady over here with her back turned to us, all right? This represents you. Your crush feels like that. Sometimes that it's like it's hard to get to you or get to know you because you are just busy doing your own thing, or you're very ambitious, you have your dreams and all of that stuff. And there's no harm in doing just that, okay? But if you're watching this video and you chose this pile, it's because you feel something for this person, obviously, because they are your crush. Yeah. And I'm feeling that they feel something for you too. Okay. They feel happy. They feel happy when you are around. And the thing is, if you would like something to happen with this individual, I think you would have to start giving them a little bit more attention. Okay. Yes, your dreams are very important and you should always focus on that. Okay, because I myself am a very ambitious individual, so I totally understand. Okay, I'm a workaholic as well, so I totally understand when you really enjoy your work and you have got these big dreams, big goals, and all of that stuff. But if you really want somebody in your life, you would have to make some space for them too. Otherwise, it'll be, what do you say, unfair to keep them hanging, right? Also with death over here, sometimes you're it's like something deep inside your crush is subconscious. I don't think for most of you they have even acknowledged this, but it's like they feel that you came into their life as a savior, okay? Like you with your energy, with you have these big dreams, you are this go-getter. And all of this stuff, you're pretty content with where you are in your life. And it's like you also have this nice energy about you, okay? This happy energy about you, because you're doing things that are making you happy and joyous. And that's why it's like they were inspired when they met you. And probably they were going through a tough time, because when I look at death, I'm getting the Five of Cups in my mind. So they could have gone through a breakup, or they could have been feeling very down on themselves, down on their luck. Like life is not really going anywhere for them. They're not doing the thing that they really want to do. And then they met you, and you came in like a knight in this white horse, okay? And you changed their life. You showed them a different way of approaching life. And your person looks out for you and looks at you because of that, okay? They really, really like this energy that you brought into their life, okay? Now, I'm gonna tell you a little bit about your crush. Who are they like as a person? So we have the skunk spirit, know your worth. Giraffe spirit, see the big picture. And we have the mouse spirit. Huh, very cute. All right, so first of all, it's like your person, when they were younger, or maybe until more recently, before you met them and something, for the longest time in their life, they probably felt that they were worthless, okay? And that they were not good looking. For some of them, they felt that they were not good looking. They did not match up to the people around them. For some of them, they did not really have friends. Now, you will see a lot of people watch these videos, right? So a lot of people have chosen pile number two. So you have to take what resonates with you. But if you don't know your crush, these are the things, keep them in mind. When you get to know them more, it'll become more apparent which is what, all right? So I'll just tell you the messages that are coming through. But yeah, for some of them, they do not have friends when they were growing up, because people thought there was something weird about them, something wrong about them. But in reality, there was nothing wrong about them. It's just that, like a skunk, their natural temperament was very different from the people around them, okay? And it makes sense, because this person has a lot of big dreams, big ambitions, okay? Big dreams, to sum it up, okay? And most of us, I don't know about you, but I think it will be true for all of us, but we do come across more, I mean, for most of us, the people in our lives don't really have ambition, okay? They're just content having a stable and secure 9-to-5. They are content making so and so amount of money, as long as they have they can go to Disneyland, or like, you know, on an occasional cruise trip or something. They're just happy with whatever they are doing in their life, and there's nothing wrong with that. Okay, there's nothing wrong in that. It's just that that kind of a nature is very different from the nature of an individual who has big dreams, right? And people who have big dreams tend to be smaller in number than the people who are just content with what life gives them. And, you know, these are the kind of people who really enjoy community a lot, right? So your person was very different from them, okay? And that's why your person always felt left out. They felt like the black sheep, somebody, and not just the black sheep, they felt like the skunk, okay, in the group that nobody wanted to interact with. They felt that there was something really, really wrong with them. It is only recently, maybe a few years back or just a few months back before they met you, that they really recognized their worth. And I think this person, that's why we have the death card on this table. You have in your subconscious picked up okay, so here's the thing. Your crush feels like this about you, right? And this is describing your crush. So it's like you came into the life and you have this energy of transformation inside of you, okay? Because you came in as a knight in shining armor, but it's represented by death, all right? So it's like your crush has the same quality that you possess as well, okay? So yeah, your crush has some problems with accepting their worth, but they're working on it, all right? And the fact that you came into the life has really inspired them to even work on it even more, all right? Even if you've not had a discussion about this at all. Also, this person, your crush, okay? They have, I'm getting Sagittarius vibes as well, okay? They don't have to be Sagittarius, but I feel that this person is somebody who is very, who is like a visionary, okay? But they're very timid as well. It's like, maybe I should keep these two cards together. It's like, when they were a kid, when they were young, they were surrounded by people who did not really understand them because their energy was very, very different. They had these big dreams, big visions and stuff, but the people around them thought small, did not have any ambition in life, or the way they saw ambition was very different from the way they see it, okay? Their scale of ambition is like 100 times bigger than the scale of ambition of the people in the circle, okay? Whether it's the family members or the kids they grew up with, the teachers that they encountered, okay? And that's why, over time, because people bullied them, because I do get bullying vibes, or people who treated them badly, they developed this thing where they were they had this problem with being courageous, okay? So it's like they were quite cowardly. And they're just starting to get out of this. So now that when you start getting to know your crush a little bit more, you'll still see a timid side to them. And you will, since you, they see, they feel that you are somebody who's so transformative and strong, right? You inspire them. I think you can inspire them to continue working on their self-worth, okay? Their self-esteem. And to be courageous, because courage is not the lack of fear. A lot of courageous people actually feel a lot of fear. Like, for example, when somebody jumps into a burning building to save children or some families or something, or even kittens or dogs or whatever, that person is terrified that they will burn to a crisp, but they still go and do it. Why? Because deep inside, they cannot look at themselves in the mirror if they knew that they had the chance to save somebody, but they did not do it, right? And that is what courage is all about. It's about overcome your, like, feeling the fear but overcoming it. So you can help them out in this aspect because they are a little timid. But when you start, you know, helping them out and they understand their worth a little bit more, they are already working on it, but it'll get better with as time goes by. You'll see that this person is a visionary, okay? Yeah. They can see things very clearly. For some of them, they are clairvoyant as well. They may know this or they may not know this. But they have some psychic gifts. But they just know things. And the more confident they become, the stronger their gift will become as well, okay? Both the psychic gift of clairvoyance, claircognizance and all of that stuff, and the regular gift of having the ability to have a big vision. Because visionaries are the people who actually change the world, right? So pile number two, that's pretty much all I'm getting for you. If you enjoyed this reading, hit the like button below and let me know what you think in the comments. And if you've not subscribed to the channel yet, please do subscribe. Also, if you would like to book a private reading with me, all the information for that is there in the description box below. So yeah, that's pretty much it for today. I hope you have a great day ahead and I'll see you later. Bye-bye. Hi, pile number three. So if you chose this marker, let's find out what does your crush feel about you. Now, when I was meditating on this marker, I got the feeling that for some of you, your crush likes to dance a lot, okay? Now, this is not going to apply to all of you who have chosen pile number three, but yeah, it's there. So I'm going to tell you what they feel about you, and then I'm going to tell you what your, who your person is like on the inside. So we have the Ten of Swords. Oh, damn. We have the Three of Swords. Wow. We have the Nine of Swords. Ouch. We have the Tower and the Knight of Wands. Are you asking about an ex, pile number three? I really think you are asking about an ex. Because this energy is so, so strong. Okay. It's like, I think a lot of you pick this pile thinking about your ex and how they feel about you. But there's a small percentage of you who actually picked it because you want to know what your crush feels about you. And I feel that something really went wrong between you and your crush. And because of that, the dynamic has really changed between the two of you. And it's like you're very scared that you may not get to speak to this person ever again, or the friendship is over, or you have missed your chance or whatever. In both the situations, the ex situation and the real crush situation, with the Knight of Wands over here, it's like your ex or this crush, both these individuals, for both these groups of people, they want to come back into your life. And they are extremely heartbroken about whatever it is that happened between the two of you. Whatever happened was very, very sudden. Neither you nor them were able to handle it in a manner that is considered mature, or if one of you handled it in a mature manner, the other did not. But whatever happened, the whatever went down between you and this person, whether it was a crush or an ex, in both situations, your relationship has changed forever. There's no going back. So I think for some of you, I'm getting for a very small percentage of you, the reason why things changed was because one person admitted their feelings before the other was ready. And that caused a lot of stress and heartbreak in your crush. Because I feel it was you who admitted it. But this is for a very small percentage of you, okay? Not for all of you. But yeah, you know, there's something that really changed this relationship. And your crush is feeling heartbroken. Maybe you have not spoken to each other for a long time. They feel that there's no coming back from this. Although they want to make the move, they want to come back. But at this point in time, I feel that this is their predominant energy. Okay. They're feeling lonely. They are stressing out. For some of them, they're having nightmares about the situation. They really don't want to lose you. And that's why once the grief settles a bit and they have accepted the thing that happened so suddenly, once they go through this period, after that, they will make the move, okay? So I think at this point of time, you should give them a little space. Allow them to go through all these feelings, understand these feelings, because everybody has the right to, you know, grieve in silence and solitude, all right? So yeah, that is them. I also feel that your crush knows that you are heartbroken as well. That you feel defeated. Okay, I'm getting a fourth message right now. It's like your crush feels you are heartbroken, you are defeated. Something really went wrong in your life. Maybe you got dumped by the person who you really loved. And this crush, I don't get the rebound energy for some of you. It could be a rebound, but it's like you definitely do have a crush on this individual. And this person wants to come in and make it better, okay? So pick the message that applies to you. If it's the ex, they will come back after they deal with this situation. If you have a crush and things really change dramatically between the two of you in the recent times, again, they will come back. Give them some time to figure things out. If you are the person who went through something really drastic, like a breakup or something, where you're very heartbroken, your crush wants to come in and really, how do I put this? Soothe is not exactly the right word. What's the word I'm looking for? It's like they want to be the shoulder that you can cry on. They want to support you, okay? Yeah, they want to be there for you. So now I'm going to tell you what your crush is like as a person. So we have Scarab Beetle, magic works through you. Elephant Spirit, learn from the past. And Koala Spirit, spirit has a plan. Okay. Wow. First of all, let's focus on this thing and this one, the elephant and the koala spirit. Basically, it's saying that your person, your crush, has gone through a lot in their life which has helped them mature and grow up, okay? There were situations where they felt like they were being restricted, forced into a box that did not really fit them. And what they did was they are the kind of person who doesn't just give in, okay? They are very good with the law of attraction. So when they really, really want something badly enough, it actually comes to them, okay? And that's why even though they have gone through a lot of, oh wow, this 5-2 and this 2-5, they're mirroring each other. Yeah, this is the thing. So whenever something goes wrong in their life, or they feel trapped or repressed or restricted or boxed in or whatever, I'm just giving a few examples. It could be something bigger than that as well, like these tower moments, okay? They've gone through things in the past and they've emerged out of it because of their own self, because this Scarab Beetle spirit gives me magician vibes from the tarot, okay? So they were the ones who actually got themselves out from those bad situations. And because of that, this person has become very, very strong, very mature, very wise. It does not matter whether they are young, like even if they are in their teens or early 20s, it does not matter. This person is very mature, far more mature than their age, okay? And with spirit as plan away, it's like this person understands that everything happens for a reason, because we have 2-5 and 3-5. It's like 2 comes before 3. So the problems and the challenges, the tower moments, they come to teach you a lesson, and you only understand what the lesson is later on, once you have processed everything, once you have worked on it, you know, and helped yourself out of the situation, put in the work to get yourself out, overcome this challenge, all of that stuff, okay? And once they do all of that stuff and they get out, they have this capacity to learn lessons, okay, from whatever goes wrong in their life. This is a very spiritual person, okay? A very old soul. A very old soul. There's something magical about this individual, okay? They can see through people. You can't bullshit this person, okay? And even if you manage to, this person will be victorious in the end. Yeah. They're very laid back as well. They enjoy their Netflix and chill sessions, okay? They like eating a lot. They like sleeping a lot. Okay. They like to take things slow, all right? So pile number 3, that's pretty much all I'm getting for you. So if you enjoyed this reading, let me know what you think in the comments below and hit the like button below. And if you've not subscribed to the channel yet, please do subscribe. Also, if you would like to book a private reading with me, all the information for that is there in the description box below. And yeah, that's it for today. I hope you have a great day ahead, and I'll see you later. Bye-bye. Hi, pile number 4. So, if you chose this marker, let's find out, what does your crush feel about you? Okay, as I was meditating on this marker over here, I got the feeling that either you or your crush really enjoy baked goodies, okay? Especially pastries with those muffins with those swirls on top. I was just getting that. So, I'm going to tell you about your person in the end, what they are like as an individual. But first, how do they feel about you? What do they feel about you? So we have the reversed High Priestess, okay. Reversed 8 of Wands, okay. Knight of Swords. 2 of Cups. Ace of Swords and the reversed 10 of Cups. Ouch. Okay. Here's the thing. See, I've got to be honest with you, even if you do not like it, like what I'm going to say next, but I feel that you need to back off a little bit. I think you're coming on a little bit too strong on this person, and they want you to really like just maintain some distance at this point in time. You want to be in a relationship with them, you see them, you like them, you're the kind of person, when you know what you like, you just go after it. And that's a great quality to have. I'm not saying that it's something bad. It's just that you should also respect people's boundaries. And the thing is that with the quality that you have, when you see someone, you go after them, in life will actually help you get a lot more than other people who don't say or speak up when they really want something, okay? And it doesn't just apply to romantic relationships. It also applies to workplace situations and your career and other relationships, other aspects of life, okay? So it's good to have this energy, but you also have to realize that in a relationship, it's not just one person. Would you be happy if you were to find out later that this person just said yes to dating you because you were pestering them so much and they wanted to get you off their back? It's gonna really hurt. It's gonna feel it's going to really pinch you in your heart, okay? Because you want them to like you right back. And at this point in time, it's like they feel that you're just coming on too strong. And they would like to, like, you know, maintain their distance a little bit from you, okay? Also, I feel that your person feels that the reason why you're so forward, and there's nothing wrong in being forward, like I said, it just, there's a right place and a right time, and you have to respect people's, the other person's boundaries as well, right? But yeah, your person feels that the reason why you come on so strong is because you have not achieved this relationship dream that you have, okay? Maybe even when you were growing up, you never saw it between your parents. Maybe your parents actually could have divorced. It's not going to apply to all of you, but it was not a happy home. And so you, deep inside, you really want to be in a happy relationship with somebody, okay? You want to prove to yourself that it is possible. It's not like history will repeat itself and you will be trapped in a bad relationship with someone who doesn't care for you either, okay? But, and your person feels that, that's mainly the reason. I don't think they have, it's like, it's something that they have felt in the subconscious, because every human being is very, very good with body language. It's just that most of us don't listen to our intuition, okay? Most of us, when we notice something weird about somebody and their body language, and it just strikes us, but our mind overrides it and we sometimes go out and make a mistake, right? So I'm just giving an example. In this situation, it's like your person has figured out the reason why you come on so strong. It's because you really, really want this happy ever after. But they have not acknowledged it, you know, consciously. Deep inside, they know it. But on the outside, if someone was to say that, they would be like, huh, that's very interesting. I didn't know that, or something like that, because it's so deep inside. Your person also feels that you're the kind of person, when you want something, you get it, okay? Which I will say is a very good trait to have. It'll get you quite far in life. And, but it's almost like when they interact with you, even if it has just been a few times, they feel that you're the one who talks too much, okay? You're the one who talks more, you don't listen as much, okay? Because it's almost like you want to convince them by talking all of this stuff about yourself and everything. You want to convince them that you are a great catch and they should totally go out with you. But yeah, seriously, I would say this. It's on you what you choose to do at the end of the day. But at the end of the day, it's like your person definitely wants you to back off at this point in time, okay? If something were to happen later, I don't know about that, but maybe they'll come around to liking you. It could happen. Most of the time, it does not. But why really degrade yourself by going after somebody who really does not want you to, you know, pester them, right? It's not a very respectful situation to be stuck in, right? But the whole thing is, I'm going to tell you about your individual. Since you have a crush on them, you want to know more about them. So we have the reverse squirrel spirit. Okay, we have the chameleon spirit. We have the crow spirit, and we have the reversed rabbit spirit. Okay, your person is the kind of person who does not believe in themselves, all right? He or she does not believe in their dreams, does not believe in themselves. They might have self-esteem issues, and they also feel that they get quite unlucky in life quite often. It's just weird thing. They feel that every time things go wrong, they blame themselves, and they're like, it's because I have bad luck. Like, I'm the unluckiest person you'll ever meet. But that is not true. Like, bad things happen to pretty much everybody on this entire planet, okay? And they're just not seeing things very clearly, all right? Also, with chameleon spirit over here, I feel your person does not know who they are on the inside. they keep changing who they are based on the people they hang out with, okay? So if they're hanging out with people who talk a lot, they'll start talking a lot too, just to fit in. Or, you know, if they're hanging out with somebody who's into occult, they'll be like, huh, that's interesting, tell me more, and all that stuff. And this helps them make a lot of friends, that is there for sure. But it's like they don't really have a personality of their own. They are like, whoever they interact with is who they become. And this is a very strong Gemini energy over here. They don't have to be a Gemini, but yeah, that is the kind of energy that I'm getting from this person. And with crow spirit and co-create with spirit, I'm getting the feeling that your person also likes to gossip a lot, okay? So this person is not a very trustworthy individual because of the fact that they can't keep their mouth shut. It's like they're so good at blending into groups and being friends with people. Like I said, they're a chameleon, right? So because of that, because when they interact with people, they just start adopting behaviors like them. It's like that it creates this false sense of bonding with the other person. So maybe you have also encountered this. Maybe that's why you feel so strongly about this person. But it's like they are not like you. They just were making you because they are a chameleon, all right? But yeah, what happens is that they tend to form these bonds with people because people think that they are just like them. And we like being around people who are just like us, right? And then this bond makes people tell them their secrets to this person. But this person is not very good at keeping secrets. They enjoy talking a lot, gossiping a lot. And that's what they do. Once they're out of the situation with this individual who has trusted them with the secret, they go and blab about it to other people. Yeah, I think this individual is not exactly a very, this individual is not a really high quality person, okay? Not because they are a bad person, good person, all of that does not really matter. It's just that they have got a lot of weak character traits that they need to work upon. They could be young, because of which they have all of this stuff. But if they work on this, anybody can change, anybody can transform. But it is not your job to get them there. It is their job, all right? You can give them feedback. That you can do as a good Samaritan, but it's on them to actually take life in their own hands and do something with it, all right? To change these qualities that are quite harmful, to be honest. Because who's going to trust you if they've eventually people do figure out that they have been blabbing? Because I have come across a person like this when I was in college, okay? And this girl was very, very good at becoming friends, making friends with people. And it was the same thing, like people would tell her their secrets because they felt so close to her, because she could talk to them about all the things that they enjoyed, okay? So she was like this chameleon. And then the very next day, she'll go and tell all this person's secret to somebody else. And she used to spread around secrets. And eventually, people do come to know. And that is like, it takes your credibility down 10, 15, 1,000 notches, okay? And then people are like, in their head, even if they are nice to you on your face, because nobody wants to be a shit person, but like, behind your back, they'll be talking shit about you, which used to happen with this girl in our college. People used to laugh about her because she was not very trustworthy. So that's the thing. This person also has a lot of character traits which are weak, okay, and they need to work on it, all right? So that's all I'm getting for you, pile number 4. If you enjoyed this reading, hit the like button below and let me know what you think in the comments. And if you have not subscribed to the channel yet, please do subscribe. Also, if you would like to book a private reading with me, all the information for that is there in the description box below. And yeah, so finally, the last reading is done. I'm completely tired. I don't know what you're going to do next, but I hope you have a great day ahead. All right, see you next time. Bye-bye.